Hey people, we are still in the Dutch village hanging out with some farmers from the Netherlands. They've come to exhibit so much that we don't know and those that we can't borrow a leaf from. I'm here with a gentleman. Hello, how are you?
Hello, I'm very well, thank you.
Okay,
my name is Ron van den Berg.
Okay, what are you exhibiting here?
I work for a company called Shoretime and we do poultry equipment.
And
poultry is very important also for Uganda. Yeah, it's because you have to feed the world, and also the population in Uganda is increasing all the time.
Okay.
And that's why we are here.
Okay.
And
have you taken time to understand how the poultry is being done here in Uganda?
Yes, I took some time already before I came.
How is it different from that?
Well,
in
here in Uganda, there are a lot of small farmers.
Okay.
Very small farmers you have here. So small farms and very large integrations.
Oh.
And
so how would you advise?
Well, I don't know, but it is very easy. Well, poultry is one of the possibilities to market, to build up your own business very easily. The investment is very small.
Okay.
But Shoretime is doing business with the larger integrations.
So what are some of the equipment or ideas that you have on board that Ugandan farmers can borrow from?
Well, the ideas are that you can start small.
Okay.
Uganda farmers can start small. They can, with a small investment, they can already start making money. Immediately.
How many birds are you talking about?
Yeah, I don't know. But the companies where we do business with,
They
have about a million layers.
Those are small.
That's not small. That's very big. These are the big integrations. They got a million layers. That means you have every day a million eggs.
Wow.
A million.
A million eggs every day.
Yeah.
So for a small farmer in Uganda, how many birds should they start with?
I think about 1,000.
1,000.
Start with 1,000 birds and then build it up from there.
Okay, just take us through the process of how a poultry farmer in Uganda should start up their poultry business. What kind of equipment should they have?
First have to decide what type of bird they will take.
Mm-hmm.
And then they must decide how many eggs they want to sell, how many eggs they can sell, and what equipment they need. They need a simple A-frame, and that's most probably where to start with.
The feed
are many suppliers here of feed, very well-known suppliers. Also some Dutch supplies of feed, but you also have some Ugandan companies who can make the feed. So that's not really the problem. The problem is really that you have to make sure that the bird is happy. So the bird must have the right temperature, not too warm, not too cold. The bird must have the water, must have the feed. If the chick is comfortable, if the chick is happy, it will lay the egg and it will have the good quality egg. Birds are not different than people. If people are happy, they also grow very well, and everything is okay. So also you have to treat the birds like people.
Okay, there are those infections that really affect Ugandan birds here. And how is it in the Netherlands?
Well, in the Netherlands, we have sometimes problems with bird flu.
Mm-hmm.
So the poultry is larger integrations, and all the houses are closed.
Mm-hmm.
All the houses are closed, and here
they shouldn't be open.
And here the houses are open. I'm not sure how much bird flu you have here, because I don't know if the bird flu here. But the houses in Holland, the houses are closed.
Okay.
In Holland, it's very difficult to get into a poultry plant, because you can bring the contamination from one plant to the other plant.
Okay.
And then here people still have to learn a little bit.
Okay, so they should always keep
the
farmhouses closed.
Yeah, and they have to check also the hygiene. So if you clean your feet when you go into the chicken, clean your hands. If you go into the chicken house, put a new clean clothes on. These things are very important, and that we still have to make a little step in.
Okay, in Uganda here, where are you located? I see Shoretime. Why are you located here in Uganda?
Well, we are not located in Uganda because we are still looking also for an agent. For an agent for the smaller equipment, with the larger business we do directly with the customers, because it's very special. Yeah, it's not.
Give people your contact so they can find you anywhere.
Well, my contacts, if you put, is a website, is www.shoretime.com, and it's very easy. You can see it on the poster.
Okay. Okay, thank you very much. Thank you for sharing your knowledge from the Netherlands. Let me hope poultry farmers here in Uganda are going to learn from what you have shared with them. So it is very easy getting to Shore Time. All you have to do is to visit their website, www.shoretime.com, and get that knowledge from the people in the Netherlands who deal in poultry. They say here in Uganda, the poultry business is very small. He has told me, the gentleman there has told me that they rear over 1 million birds on a farm. You can imagine how many birds that can be reared in the Netherlands. So we have some poultry farmers here in Uganda. Let me go and check them out today and see what they have for you. You're still with me, Ruth Nasoje, taking you through what is happening at the Dutch Village.